he has a line item veto, so he can veto Reggie. And I don't think that money's calculated.
The governor had put forth a budget that actually gave us a tax reduction when we came back, when the Democrats came back, we went in the opposite direction, raised taxes in a year that Virginians are already struggling. So I'm hoping that we can still come out of this with some reprieve for Virginia taxpayers and moving in the direction of leaving money in pockets of those who are
now. He's been calling this the backwards budget, right? So you have to go back to December when he released his version of the budget, and he came out and he said Virginia is losing jobs to North Carolina, to Tennessee, to Kentucky, and so what do? We're gonna cut the taxes that working people pay, right? Middle class taxes. That's what his vision was. And he said, I'm gonna try to pay for it with some of these things like these sales tax increases, which I didn't personally agree with that part of it. I think there was gonna be some back and forth with the governor on that. But his overall vision was a strong vision. It was keeping jobs and growing the economy in Virginia. What did they do instead? They kept the sales taxes. And so it ends up being like this $2.6 billion tax increase, sales tax increase, in a time where we are already in a recession or heading into a recession. And so it doesn't make any sense. And this has been the theme of the General Assembly for me, was why are you trying to hurt the middle class so much, and why are you holding the middle class hostage to these left-wing ideals like Reggie?
Virginia needs to stop letting the federal government dictate to us what we're going to do about our electricity.
It's always important when you can build those relationships. I was on the Transportation Committee. It was one of my committee assignments. I got to build some relationships with a lot of the Democrats who are on Arlington, because if you've been to Arlington, one of their number one issues is towing. Everyone's being towed constantly. So when they're elected, they're given a mandate to deal with this issue. Not a big issue for Bedford County, but something that I was able to sit down with them on many, many different days and hear about these problems, help them shepherd some of these bills through the Transportation Committee to get them to the floor. And my hope is that in the future, you know, we build these relationships, we help them out with local issues, and my hope is that in the future they'll help us in return in some of our Bedford County bills that came through. They brought this bill to the floor to allow localities to ban gas-powered leaf blowers. It's just a power reach. And so I took the lead on fighting that in the House of Speech and said, you can take our leaf blowers from our cold, dead hands.
No teacher wants to suspend a student, but every teacher wants to maintain order in their classroom. We need to give teachers and school administration the tools that they need to maintain order, and we need to keep this ideology that pushes restorative justice. All of these ideologies are being pushed down into our school.
The key to attracting businesses are safe communities, which we have great safe communities, thanks to our law enforcement, Commonwealth's attorneys, and good schools. And Bedford has great schools, thanks to our Board of Supervisors and school board folks. So, and law enforcement, who keeps good order and keeps them safe. So eventually you can get businesses moving in and bring families who want to live here and recruit businesses, and that's, and you educate them, and they can have jobs
and have affordable homes, and we have good schools and all the things that the counties represent. Who would want to live in a big city right now? If you look at the big cities, who would want to be there? They want, people are moving out into more rural areas, and I think if we could just do what we can on making housing affordable, making these communities places where people want to live, I think it's like they're here there, right? So I think protecting our farms is really important. I also think, echoing what these gentlemen said, our culture. Culture is so important, and everything is going to be downstream from that. And I'm seeing some of the ideas that we saw come across on culture war issues. I know that not everybody likes to fight those issues, but at a certain point, they impact the schools, they impact the businesses, it flows down to everything. And so I think we need to be fighting on those issues.